going on, people? Welcome to You Know The Score. It's your boy Shingy London. I've got Man City fan Yannicka with me today. You know what I'm saying? How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
Yeah, I'm not too bad. You know, I'm not too bad. I'm too bad. You see, you're not sour about the result on the weekend?
I think City are very predictable. So as much as I wanted us to win,
yeah,
I kind of knew that what happened might have happened. So yeah, City don't really get me down for too long.
So you said that you were kind of expecting it.
Well, I think because it's Spurs have always been a bit of a bogey team for us in general. Yeah. Like, we struggle against, no matter how good City are, we still seem to struggle against Spurs. So
yeah,
I think there's always that element that even if they played really badly, they still might have got a result against us, which is obviously not good. And also, defensively, Mourinho is brilliant, do you know what I mean? And we're struggling to break teams down at the moment. So it's just a combination of the both. I think City on top form,
yeah,
that game ends differently, but we're not on top form. So and Spurs are, so yeah.
That's true because like you guys like had like 22 shots at their goal. I had like about what 65% possession. Like it was like a proper one-sided game. I was thinking like how the hell, especially in the first half, I was like, how the hell are Spurs 1-0 up? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And like it was just I don't know what City were doing. Like what why do you think you're not ruthless in front of goal? Because you say that you're struggling to break teams down, isn't it?
Yeah. So last season I said it, we weren't clinical enough. And it sounded crazy at the time because I think we still scored the most amount of goals in the league.
Yeah.
We just weren't clinical enough. And I think we have so many chances. Like, we should be scoring a lot more, even though we are outscoring most Premier League teams, obviously not this season, but in general we are. We're still lacking that, you know, that clinicalness to our game. And I think people say Pep's been found out. I don't believe that. I just think that it's simply, you know, these teams always set up how Mourinho set up. That's not a surprise to City. And I think, you know, we did have the chances there. We had 5 shots on target. They had 4. Do you know what I mean? So attack-wise, they weren't better than us. It's just, for some reason, we can't seem to finish our chances. And at the other end, we're conceding with our first chance against us. So that's really hindering us. And then I think it must be a mentality thing, because normally with City, if we concede, we're still in the game. But nowadays, it seems to be if they get the first goal,
you lot are struggling.
So they're going to get is a draw. Yeah. And it's bad.
It seems that way. Do you think, like, when you say it's down to mentality thing, like, then, like, your frugalness at the back, do you think that's because you've kind of, like, lost your spine, sort of, like, you lost company, and then Fernandinho, he struggles to stay fit. So, like, your spine defensively is kind of gone. Do you think you miss those or two especially?
Yeah, I think that's the thing, because with City, people are saying like, oh, they should have got replacements, but the players that we've lost are not easy to replace. You know, David Silva, not easy to replace. Vincent Kompany, it's not really about him on the pitch. With his performances on the pitch, we can replace Kompany.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
What he did behind the scenes, and that captain and, you know, that leader that he was, we're struggling to replace that. I think Diaz has come in. Diaz looks very company-like. He gives me company vibes when company first came. He seems like a leader. He's young. So if he is a leader, he can lead us for a long time. So, yeah, I'm quite happy to see him. He has settled in quite well. It's early days for him, and he seems to be doing all right. Obviously, we've got a defence now. Laporte is great, but he was on his own. So now we've got Diaz and Laporte. We've got Aki in. Obviously, Aki struggling with fitness. But I think defensively we're doing okay. I just think because of the lack of Fernandinho, very end-to-end. And obviously when it's end-to-end, you make mistakes, you know. So I wouldn't say Spurs didn't make a single mistake. It's just when they did make the mistakes, we didn't put them away. So it was irrelevant at the end of the day. But I think, you know, I would never really blame our defence for that performance, because I just think we did enough to go forward to win that game, and we didn't. So,
yeah. So, like you said, you didn't, like, which I'm happy about anyway, because that puts Man United ahead of Man City in the table. But like, you guys didn't win that game, and I think you guys are ninth in the table form guide. So I think you've won two games, drawn two, and lost one in So that's two games. You've won two games in five. Does that concern you? Does that concern you? Your form guide, because considering obviously the Liverpool, you know, they've started flying again.
Yeah, I think we haven't. It's obvious that we haven't started the season well. At the beginning, I was like, it's early days. We've not had a pre-season. We've got players out, you know. We didn't have a striker for quite a few games. Oh. Then, you know, Gabby's come back. Aguero's still not back. So I think over the season, I think we will get better. I can't see City remaining like this all season and not being able to score, because the way we play football, we always create chances. I just think with David Silva out, the main focus and all of the pressure is on De Bruyne, who isn't actually having the best start to the season himself.
Yeah.
So it's kind of, there's a lot of pressure on him. Without Fernandinho, there's even more pressure on him. Oh. And I think the way we're playing at the moment is not good enough, but I don't think that will last the whole season. I think because of the way we've started the season,
oh.
I think we'll still be in and about in a title race. I don't think we're going to be ruled out, but I think we're kind of, if we get too far behind, we're going to struggle. So we need to pick up some form. We need a run of wins.
Oh.
Spurs away is never an easy game for us regardless. So I think that was a bad place to kind of start if we want a run of wins.
Yeah.
But we'll see what happens. I think with City, I can't rule City out. I've seen us come from positions that we shouldn't be winning the league to win the league. So I wouldn't rule us out, but I think this season's a bit of a transition for us in terms of, you know, David leaving, Aguero not fit.
I think you guys will be in and around it. But for some reason, I just think Liverpool are probably going to be too strong and too consistent, you know, because, you know, they haven't really dropped any more points at the moment. So, yeah. I don't know. City, who knows, man? You may want to focus on the Champions League this season.
I think that's where the players seem to be focused, because the performances in the Champions League are completely different
than
the Premier League. So I think the players kind of have the eyes on the Champions League.
Mm.
But I think that's really risky. I always say it. I think it's really risky to put all your eggs in a cup basket. I think if you put all your eggs in the league basket,
you've
got quite a good chance of winning it. But I think with the Champions League, it's one of them competitions, a little bit of luck.
Mm.
And winning it, and you know, a bit of bad luck, and you're out. So,
definitely.
Yeah, I think City, the way we are with luck, I think it's very risky to kind of put all our eggs in that basket. In terms of Liverpool has started okay. They didn't start particularly well, but they got the results. And I think Klopp is a winner, you know, and he seems to get the best out of his team, and they seem to be getting performances. I think long term, though, they do say defences win you titles. And I think with their long-term injuries to their key defenders, it's whether Matip can stay fit. Because if he gets injured, it's a different scenario. So I don't know whether they'll win it. I think they're good enough to win it. But I think with the injuries that they've got in their defence, it's whether they can maintain it for the whole season.
I hope not, man.
We'll see. I hope not, man.
I wish I could, you know, be confident and say, look, we'll try and get in the mix, Man United, but I can't see it. So at this moment in time, I'm praying that Tottenham stay consistent, but Spurs will be Spurs, you know what I'm saying? So they love that bottle. So, I can't.
It's interesting, because normally you'd be like Chelsea straight away, but under Lampard, because Lampard isn't proven himself yet, there's a lot of questions about who can win it. And that's why I think it is very early days for this league. And it's not because they're not good enough to win it. Of course, you know, Spurs are good enough to win it with that squad that they have. You know, Chelsea are good enough to win it with their squad. But I just think I think with the league as well, and that's a reason for Klopp to actually win it, is because they've been there, done that.
Yeah,
and I think if it gets to the end and it's say for example it's them three at the end, I think Liverpool will come out on top just because they've done it before. Yeah. So we'll see what happens, but yeah, I think it's a bit early at the moment. Everyone's been a bit shaky. Even Liverpool, like sometimes when they're winning, the performances aren't great.
But they, so, yeah, they're scraping the wins. Definitely. I mean, you know, though, I think like in recent weeks there were some Man City fans before obviously Pep Guardiola signed his new contract that was saying that they'd like to get Pep out and bring in, was it the Leipzig manager or Pochettino?
Oh, yeah.
I mean, you know, are you happy that, you know, Pep has extended his contract? Because I wasn't sure he was gonna renew. And I thought maybe he'd want to take a holiday, but he decided to renew for a few more years.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Pep. I thought he would leave. I thought after his mum died, I thought he needs a bit of time to grieve. I thought he would take a little bit of time out, maybe even come back, I don't know. But I think it's quite good in a way that he has stayed, because he's never shown that commitment to a club before. So it's nice to see it. Everyone kind of judges him. Can he win the Champions League? I think if he left now, they would say he failed at City because he didn't win it. So I think he kind of needs to stay to prove himself, you know, as much as we probably need him to stay in terms of for consistency. Because I think City don't like sacking managers. Like, I know we've sacked a few over the past, you know, 10 years or whatever, but I think we don't like, we're not that sort of club that want to sack a manager every time he's, you know, in a bit of bad form. And I think if you look at it from a trophy point of view, he's won us, I think it's 8 trophies. It might even be more now. So he's won quite a lot of trophies in the time that he's been with us. So I think, I know a lot of fans say like, oh, you need to win the Champions League. Yes, we do need to win the Champions League. But I think if you said to me 5 years ago, would you take back-to-back titles, you know, the Carabao Cup 3 years in a row, the FA Cup, the Community Shield,
yeah,
4 of them in one season, like, I probably would have been like, yeah, I'll take that. So I think after he leaves, people will realise how well he actually did. But right now, it just feels like he's failed because of the Champions League element of it. So I think it'd be nice for him to stay and win it. That's best case scenario. Whether he will extend, if he doesn't, I don't know. But
yeah, I mean, you know, I think possibly, you know, you said that he may need your time to grieve. I think maybe he possibly wanted to stay as for a distraction purpose.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? To keep his mind in the game. And that's probably obviously increased his hunger and his desire to try and succeed at Manchester City. So, I mean, I guess you're not one of those Man City fans that have any grave concerns then.
No, I think for me, I always say that any manager we get in is going to be a risk. So if, say, for example, we say, let's get rid of Pep, he's not good enough.
Yeah.
I can't think of a single manager that can come in and is guaranteed to win Man City the Champions League. Do you know what I mean? People say Klopp's a great manager. Yes, he's won it at Liverpool, but he's not won it at every team he's been to. So I'm not saying that he couldn't win it at City, because maybe he could, but it's never a guarantee. You know, Jose Mourinho was fantastic with Chelsea. You know, they should have won it with him. He left and they win it with Roberto Di Matteo.
Yeah, exactly. You know what
I mean? So I think Champions League, it could even be a case of Pep doesn't win it, the next manager comes in who's not as good and wins the Champions League. That the Champions League is a cup competition. It's very unpredictable. You know, Pochettino could have won it before Klopp, you know, realistically, you know, if that game went differently. So I don't know. I think it's, as a City fan, I want us to win the Champions League, but I don't want us to prioritize it.
Yeah.
I think we win it when we least expect it. That's what I think.
I see. And today was announced that fans are going to be allowed back to the stadium in some places in the UK. We don't know yet. I mean, when they are you going to be going back to Manny to attend any of their games at all if you can?
I don't know how it's going to work with City, because I know at one point they were saying everyone's season tickets are going to kind of go in, all the season ticket holders are kind of going to go in like a draw, and then people will get drawn out. So I don't know how it will work. I don't think I've received anything about my season ticket personally from City, but so I don't know how it's going to work. I would like to go back. I think I'm just as likely to catch it as football as I am at work or going to Tesco, do you know what I mean? Yeah. So I'd rather be risking my life to watch football. But yeah, I think it would be nice to go back. I think I think teams are missing fans. I know a lot of people say that, you know, fans don't really make that much difference because they're professional footballers, but I think they do. I think games like Tottenham, where we need a goal, the fans are going to make a difference in, you know, in scoring the goal. So, and City have struggled to get goals, and that's ever since the fans weren't there. So I'm not saying we're the reason why they score so many, but I think it does play a part. And especially like games where we've dropped points this season.
Yeah,
I don't think we're dropping them points if the fans are on their case.
Of course, because it makes the players a bit more tense, a lot more aware of what's going on, you know, and a lot more switched on, you know, because they've got people or fans hounding them, you know. Yeah. I mean, but yeah, no, it'll be good. It'll be good because, you know, I miss going to Man United games. So it's been very stressful, man. But we'll see how it works out.
Yeah.
See how it works out. But Jan, thanks for joining me. Where can they find you? Where can they find you?
On Twitter, it's at Yannicka, YANNICK, and then 3 A's. And on YouTube, it's YanCityENT.
YanCityENT. Well, thanks for joining me once again. It's been your boy, Shingy London, so Shingy _ LDN. Make sure you follow the YouTube channel, you know the score, the Twitter and the Instagram page, YKTS Football. My Twitter and Instagram is Shingy _LDN. But yeah, it's been Shingy, it's been Yannicka. We've been talking Man City. So you know the score. And we're out. Bless.